Hello, this is Solar PV TV from Intersolar Munich 2016. And we are together with Guobin, who is in charge of the energy storage business at BYD. Ni hao.
Ni hao. Thank you. Ni hao.
So, Guobin, you are one of the, let's say, pioneers in energy storage in BYD and also in the world, actually, because this is one of the pioneering companies in the technology. So could you tell us very shortly, what is the story of energy storage at BYD?
I think we started in 2008, which we see there is a potential market in the future. So BYD always like a long-term views. So and but always, you know, like the solutions, we need solid technologies. So starting in 2008, we self-developed the technology through battery management, PCS, system integration for the residential, commercial, utility scale storage systems.
So now we are at Intersolar, so let's focus on the applications for the solar industry. And you have the whole range of products, actually, yes?
Yes.
So now we have this Henxiao.
Yes.
So could you tell us more about Mini-S by BYD?
Yes. So Mini-S is the product we developed to especially Europe, especially Germany markets and UK as well. So there's self-consumption applications, means you have solar system already in the roof. Then you generate over, I mean, in the new one, you over generate the power. Then you can use the storage to solve the power, then use another time. By this way, you can avoid selling at cheap, but buying at a high expensive price. And also you can provide off-grid capability, means if there's some outage, although Germany utility is pretty strong, but still it's a capability.
But it's changing, yeah? And actually we are speaking now about the technology revolution, yeah?
Yes, that's right.
So this is just storage or there is also inverter inside?
Oh, this one is AC interface, means we integrate the battery and the inverter, bi-directional inverter, integrate one cabinet, so it's easier to install for the EPCs, right? Yeah, exactly. So AC systems.
Okay, so let's go to see another solutions that you have. So this one is without inverter, yes?
Yes, this is without. We call it a B-box. It's battery for short, right? And it's modular design through 2.5 kilowatts hours per unit. We can multiple this to a larger scale systems. Yeah, this is a, you know, sometimes in the market.
So which is the application for this?
It's similar, but it's battery only. That means if you try to build a system, you need inverters, right? And you need the connections, because in the market, there's some supplier only provide the batteries. But so the customer needs some flexibility to select either DC only or the full integrated systems. Yeah.
And what is the size?
This one is up to 12 kilowatt hours. Yeah, with different number of the battery modules. Yeah.
So depending on the customer needs, you can...
Yeah, it's scalable. So each unit is like 2.5 kilowatt hours. So 5, 7.5, 10, 12, this is scalable. Yes.
But BYD is not only about small, of course, storage solutions. Yes. It's also about commercial and also about utility scales.
Yes.
So maybe let's first focus on the utility scale, yeah, because it's quite interesting. So you are providing the whole container, the whole solution, plug and play, I would say, yes?
Yes, nearly plug and play. So utility scale project usually like a remote area, and it's like outdoor rating. So the system needs a kind of a housing. We try to make the project process easier and lower risk. So containerized system is the right fit. So we can assemble every component in the factory and make it pre-qualified, pre-testing. The customer can verify the process of the testing before shipping, right? So the product is already qualified. Then when the container arrives to site, it's really like easy to install. Just put into a concrete pad, make the connections, then the engineer commissioning on the system, a couple of days, the one container can operate. And then this is a low risk. It's a less minimum on-site job, which can save the project developers investment.
So which was, let's say, the biggest project that you ever done with this utility scale?
For the utility scale, if we're talking about a kilowatt, you know, like storage, we have two parameters. One is for power, which is a bi-directional inverter. The other one is energy, which is a battery sizing, kilowatt hours. So the largest project we have delivered is 31.5 megawatt single projects, full frequency relation in the US. If we're talking about the largest battery system, I think should be the one inside our campus. It's a 20 megawatt, 40 megawatt hours, yes.
And this is like, let's say, the solution that you are only proposing to the customers who are starting the new projects, or it can be also applicable for the projects which are already existing?
I think it's flexible, right? Sometimes the projects is only batteries, only solar, or solar plus battery. It depends on the business model. So most important thing for the final customer is to give them the confidence, have a strong, solid payback. Right. Once we define the projects, product for the customer, and prove it's like a business model is work, then the project can real solid. Right.
So yesterday, Gobin, we had this great event organized by VID. Mm-hmm. It was first disruption, let's say, event when you proposed fully sustainable power solution based, of course, on the storage. Yes. So do you have any proven data that it's really better business for the investors than just solar?
So especially for residential right now, you see the solar FIT is ramping down. So it's really hard for solar only system developed in the market. But you see when the resident or the owner of the system generate power to the utility, they get less and less for the feed-in tariff. So it's still the electricity rate, which is a customer buying power from the utility, is higher and higher. Some issue is the tax, some issue is like the energy cost. So it's really make more sense to generate the power by yourself, but storage and use by yourself, right? So you see the battery is really helping this, yeah.
And did you also notice increased demand for the commercial solar plus storage solutions?
Yes, it's commercial is quite similar to the residential because it's a sizing issue. So compared to your houses or apartments, the commercial projects normally is like a warehouse, like a store, company stores, or like a factory, something like that. So it's a sizing issue. The business model is quite similar. So it's like a, so that's
also the question of independence sometimes, yeah? Because people they would like to be really fully independent. Yeah,
yeah, this is one interesting topic. People feel like they have their own power resources.
You are working since 12 years, yes, for BID. And did you meet Mr. Wang Huangfu?
Sure, we meet Chairman Wang often. Yeah, not that often. Yeah, compared to his daily life.
How does it look like to work with visionary?
Once he think this is a real bright future, he have the confidence and the passion to make it happen, right? Just like a BYD, build your dreams. It's, sometimes people think this is a dream. It's like, oh, you're kidding, right? This is I don't know when will happen. But you see like the electric vehicles, renewables from solar, from batteries. If you back to 10 years earlier, people were thinking about it, a long time future. But today,
crazy guy, yeah.
Yeah, sometimes kind of crazy, but time will prove us. Yeah, we select the right way and we make effort to make it happen.
So you have to be proud, yeah.
Yeah, for sure.
Okay, thank you so much, Gobin. And let's see, maybe in Shenzhen, I will visit Solar PVTV. We will visit your factory. Maybe we'll have also opportunity to speak with your chairman. Thank you so much. And
thank you.
Really, thanks for bringing energy storage to the solar industry. Thank you so much.